Welcome back, my dear class 11 student. Today our subject is business studies, and today we'll discuss another type of cooperative society, that is housing cooperative society or cooperative housing society. As the name suggests, this is for housing. The society is built for housing. Okay. Now let's take an example, and through example you just understand what is the main motive of housing cooperative society, why this society actually set up, and what is the need of this type of society. Okay, so now housing cooperative society, let's take an example. Now one day a man is walking on the road and suddenly he saw a big house, and seeing this house, he actually dream about this house, and he said by himself, I wish I had a house like that. So he is actually want to make this type of house. Okay, so but he has not sufficient fund, he has no fund to make this type of house. So now he is thinking, how can we make this house? Now one day again he is roaming around in the road, and suddenly he heard about this housing cooperative society. So he went there and heard about this, and he decided that he is the part of, or he want to be a member of this housing cooperative society. Now what was that? That's what he wanted to member of this housing cooperative society. No, the answer is, the housing cooperative society actually built with different members of different social person. So this is, suppose, housing cooperative society, and there is different member, housing cooperative society. How they work? This housing cooperative society's member actually wants and gather this small fund, because they have not big fund so that they can own, make their own house. So they gather for their members small fund, and this small fund they actually distribute the flat or duplex, whatever called flat or house, in a big area, each and every member. And for this, one thing also, to build this society, this housing, the members also actually they work like a labor for making their own house. So they can feel, this is my own house we make in our own. This is the actually make hand to their, when they are making the house, the laborer actually supply different cement, their stone, and they himself hand, by their own hand they can supply it, so they can feel, this is your hour, we are actually making, but this member are making of their own house. This is also there, not only the fund, but also their own labor they can invest in there. So by two things, the small funds as they accumulated and that provided to that their houses, and they can easily get that, and of their own hand they also helps to others to make their own, or also helps their himself actually to own their own houses. Okay, so this is the main motive of housing cooperative society. Who has no sufficient fund, they come together and build and accumulate a large fund, and this large fund they actually provide a place, and for this place they build up different small building or flat, and this flat actually distributed different member as per their needs. So that is all about the motive of housing cooperative society, and that man actually gets at last their own house in this way. So this is actually through the story you can understand what is housing cooperative society. Their main motive is to distribute house where not sufficient funds, and that's what you have to remember this housing cooperative society through a small fund, and you have to also give your own labor to make this building or houses. So thank you for today. Hope you all understand. Hope you are well and safe. Thank you.